Welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology video series. This video will review the normal histology of skeletal muscle. Muscle is broken down into three classifications: skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle. Each of these groups has characteristic differences in structure, which lead to specialized functions. This video will focus solely on skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscle is what we traditionally think of when we think of muscle. It allows for the body's voluntary movements and is often attached to bone via tendons. This slide, which will be the focus of the remainder of the video, is a cross-section of a human tongue. It is number 36A and can be found in the University of Rochester Histology folder in the NanoZoom Digital Pathology slides. The tongue not only has muscle tissue, but also glandular and nerve tissue. The skeletal muscle is primarily located in the deep tissues of the tongue. One primary characteristic of skeletal muscle is the presence of striations, as can be seen here and throughout the tongue. The appearance of these striations is due to the presence of sarcomeres. These are the fundamental unit of muscle fibers and are composed of actin and myosin filaments. The overlapping of these two filaments allows the muscle to contract. These striations run in several different directions. The varying direction of these striations is important because it allows the muscle to contract in several different directions. Another characteristic of skeletal muscle cells, also known as myofibrils, is that they are cylindrical in shape. In addition, each cell is multinucleated, with these nuclei located primarily on the outer edges of the cell, as seen here. Thank you for watching. This concludes our review of skeletal muscle histology.